Last fall, I moved to a new apartment and I lost something very dear to me. I had to get rid of one of my microwaves. Yes, microwaves. Plural. Now, many asked me, why did I own two microwaves? And I can't think of a more ridiculous question. Why do people own both an iPad and a laptop? Why do people eat at the Rainforest Cafe? Simple. It's the same reason I used to own two microwaves. It's frickin' luxurious. You know what they used to call me? They used to call me Two Microwaves Peacock. But now I'm only half the man. Moving is just the worst, though. It's worse than having only one microwave. My whole moving experience was rough. You see, my landlord wouldn't let me renew my lease, so I found myself in a position where I had 30 days to find a new apartment, or else I'd be homeless. I live in the great city of Seattle, but what's not so great is that it's crazy expensive and getting only more and more expensive. Like a micro apartment that's roughly the size of a parking space goes for $1,000 a month. Who can afford that? Not me. So finding a place to live that I could actually afford was proving to be very difficult and very nerve-wracking. With a little over a week left to find a place to live, I went to this open house for a studio apartment. And usually, I don't go to open houses, because in Seattle, if an apartment is affordable and they're doing an open house for it, literally hundreds of people will show up. And that is exactly what happened. But guess what? I still beat them anyway, because I'm just that dang charming. But don't let these microwaves and open houses fool you. I'm still that wild and crazy feral party animal y'all know and love. For instance, you know that weird drunk guy on the bus? Sometimes that's me. But do you want to know the absolute craziest thing I have ever done? The craziest. Get this. I was unemployed from late 2013 to mid-2014 and rarely left my apartment so I could save money. Another fun place to be. I wholeheartedly recommend it. Now, being long-term unemployed is a lot like when you're a kid and school's out for summer. Except in this case, you fear for your life while watching your bank account deplete as you drink box after box of wine. A pro tip, if you ever find yourself in that situation, just take the bag of wine out of the box, because it's much easier to drink that way. It's like an adult Capri Sun. But I solved all that, okay? Now I work as the social media manager at an alt-weekly newspaper in Seattle called The Stranger. If you're ever in Seattle, just pick one up and check out my name in the masthead. It's pretty cool though. When we report on things, I can often see that we have a real tangible effect on the city, and I really like playing a part in that. We're a pretty leftist newspaper though, and I like telling my conservative family that I'm a pawn for the liberal media spreading the good news of socialism. For some reason, some of my family members seem to be under the impression that I write for the paper, and I don't. Sorry, I'm not that cool, I just tweet and Facebook all day. I've contributed to One Piece though. We do this thing called the Regrets Issue. At the end of every year, we submit things we regret or screwed up, so here's one of mine. Zach Peacock, the Stranger's social media manager, regrets not going to the doctor for the cough he's had for a couple months because now a coworker is berating him for it and insisting Mr. Peacock needs a girlfriend to encourage him to take care of himself so things like this won't happen. Yeah, that's a true story. I am 24 years old, and now that I've made it to my mid-20s, adulthood isn't this brand new, weird, or exciting thing anymore. For better or worse, it's normal. From here, I see myself going one of two ways. I'm either gonna head more towards the middle, or I'm gonna veer off into some strange land out there on my own. Well, it's time to go full speed off the beaten path, and I'm gonna need at least three more microwaves.